Hi, I'm Joe, and I'm going to show you how to mod a controller today. This is the finished product right here. Just a normal controller, but on the back there's the rapid fire button. Hold it down, and you should have rapid fire. It's great for like Call of Duty 4 and stuff, for like the pistols and the G3, all the semi-automatic guns like the snipers and stuff. First things first, you want to take out the battery pack. Also, look in the bottom right corner there. I don't know if you can't see it on my computer probably, but it says TP3. If you look in there, kind of on the green like microchip, it'll say TP3. And I know TP3 controllers work for modding. I'm not sure about any other ones, but because this is one controller out of two that I modded, and both of them have said TP3. So once you've taken your controller apart and I show you where to connect the wire and stuff, I recommend just taking a plain old like wire that has two ends exposed like that, and then just touch it to the points, which I point out later. Just touch the wire to those points while you're playing the game, and then if rapid fire works, then go ahead and mod your controller. If it doesn't, then your controller probably doesn't work. And don't be discouraged right away if it doesn't work, because when I first tried to mod my controller, and I tried with just a wire to see if it worked, it didn't work right away. And I screwed around with it for like 15 minutes, and then it worked. So, first things first, you'll have to unscrew your controller. I just have like a micro screwdriver right here. This is just a flathead screwdriver, a mini flathead, which will work just fine. If you really want to do good, I guess you can go out and get a T8 Torx, security proof. Because just a plain TA Torx doesn't have the little hole. If you want, you could probably use a flathead to break out the little peg in the middle of the screw, but this a flathead will do fine. Then you're going to want to unscrew the screws, which are there, there, and there. And then on the other side, same spots. Boom, boom, and boom. And there's also a hidden screw under the sticker in the middle right there. And once you've got those all unscrewed, I recommend putting them in a baggie just so you don't lose them. There should be 7 total screws. Then, this is the controller I've unscrewed. Tilt the controller upside down, unless you want to tape down these buttons and these buttons and then the middle button. Otherwise, you can just turn the controller upside down. And then first you got to take out the battery pack. Then you should just be able to kind of pull on it gently. It should come right apart. There's the back. Here's the microchip. And then here's the other half. These rubber pads are on, the buttons are on the other side of these. But you can just set this down for now. As you can see on this, there's only one rumble pack, because I cut one off to make room for the button. And what I did was there's the little one, and then there's a big one. And the little one vibrates faster, which makes the controller shake more. So what I did was I switched the rumble packs by pulling out this little, see that white thing right here? You can just pull that out if you want. Can I let you see? When you have your controller apart, this will be easier to see, but here, I'll try to do it on the other side. This right thing right here, it comes out. That's a rumble pack. And then what I did was I switched them around, because the place where you're going to put the button, that's where the little one is, and you don't want to cut the little one off because the little one vibrates more. And then when you switch them around, then you can just cut the other one right in half, as you can see, like I did right there. I just cut it off right there. And then once you've done that, then you can go drill a hole in your controller. I drilled a hole on the right side. And then there's these little ridges that the vibrator fits into right here. And then you just want to drill the hole right on the left side of those, so that it pokes out in a good spot on the back. That's where the button pokes out. And as you can see, I drilled the hole right there. And you want to drill it at an angle. You don't want to drill it straight back. Otherwise, the button will poke out straight back, and that'll feel weird. You want to kind of drill it at an angle, like that way. And make sure you don't drill up too high. Otherwise, you'll see that when you put the green chip back in, that the button won't fit under it. So when you drill the hole, then you can put the button in there and then tighten it. Like my button has like a bolt on the outside here, this like hexagonal bolt, and you just twist that around it and then it screws it in place kind of. And then you can connect the two wires to the button here. And then when you've done that, then you can place this back in there. Make sure the springs are lined up on the back side here, that otherwise it won't fit in there. See, now I've just pushed the springs in, now it fits. There's the rumble pack. Make sure you put that in there. And it'll help if the wire's facing down so it doesn't get in the way. The red and black wire right there. Make sure it's facing down. And then when the wires are connected to the push button, mine aren't right now. They're just connected to the controller where I soldered them, which I'll show you where to solder them right now. Then you can solder them. And here's what my soldering iron looks like right here. Just a, like a, can't remember how many watts, but it works. And here's the solder. You need a rosin core solder. Any size will work. And then here's my wire. This is a 24 gauge wire, but the pain, it's annoying because it's double insulated. You want 24 gauge, but if it looks thinner than this, that's okay, because it probably will be, because the insulation won't be as thick. I just chose some thick insulated wire, 24 gauge though. And then when you're soldering it, you want to connect the wires. One of the wires will always go to this spot right there. You can see there's three points, 1, 2, 3, and you connect one wire to the middle point. Make sure the solder doesn't touch the top or bottom points, because that'll screw something up. So just solder it to the middle point. Then down here, there's two points, or down here, sorry. There's two points, one on the left, one on the right. And the one on the right is the one you want to solder it to. There's also other places you can solder. You can solder it to the top one of these three, but that would be the second wire. The first one always goes to the middle. The second one can go down here to the right, to the top up here, or in fact, it can even go to the player one LED, to the very, just at the, touching the bottom of the player one LED. You can solder it there, but I did that with my first mod, and this is what happens now. I'll put my battery pack back in. Shelby, get out of here. Sorry about that. I'm not going to refilm this, though, because this is like my fourth time filming this. But yeah, the first two LEDs don't work, just because I soldered it to the LED and screwed something up. But yeah, so that's why I recommend just soldering it to the bottom right one, right there. And then when that's done, you'll want to go up, turn on your Xbox, and test it out. And first you need to put the battery pack back in, like so. And just leave it. Leave it unscrewed, like leave the top off, that way if you need to change anything, you can change it easy. Then you need to put this rubber pad on, which was on the buttons, like that's the other one for the D-pad. I need to take the rubber pad and stick it on there, and it'll line up with the black dots. Then you just like hit the center button and the controller should turn on. Then you can go try it out. And if this controller turns off, don't be nervous, that'll happen. Sometimes just take out the battery and plug it back in. I think it has to do some like with the way you're holding the controller, so just try to keep the controller steady, and then it should work, and it shouldn't turn off as much. And then when you're playing the game, just like going to a private match or something, hit your button, and if it works, then that's great. Then you take the pad off, put it on this side of the controller, line up the rubber pad, and then you'll notice if you try to put it on, if you try to connect the controller, that it probably won't fit because the wires will get in the way of something. So what I did was I just took a scissors and I cut that right there. You can see it's like a bare edge that I'm rubbing my finger against. And if you look right above it or right below it, you see it's not bare because you'll see those two points sticking up kind of. It's hard to see, sorry. But I cut it right there so that it would fit right there. And it wouldn't hit the wires. And then when you're doing the mod, you'll see like where it'll fit. And then when you're done, just keep the button side down. Let the vibrator kind of fall into the slots. And then put the controller together. And then screw it in and it should work. There you go. That's how to mod your controller. And again, this is what it'll look like in the end after you screw it all together. There's just that button on the back. And then, that's the modded controller. Thank you.